Hi, Cancer. Welcome to your reading with me, Cindy. Cancer, we're going to find out this week through the dark and the light goddesses what your superpower or your strength is, what your kryptonite, your weakness is, what your nemesis, the thing that comes around at the worst time but makes you stronger is, and what your next assignment is. So these are always really fascinating. This is the first time I've incorporated these decks to do this type of reading. And yeah. Interesting. So, what are we going to get? Let's see, Cancer. Cancer, I think this is going to be the reading to topple readings. Can we just actually take a moment just to recognize what happened when I was shuffling out? If you're this spot, that is your next assignment. Okay, right? Working with the dark and the light goddess deck. I tried to hold it up to the camera for as long as possible because I know it's sped up. So if I hold something up for like a few seconds, it literally in speed up, it's like poof, poof. So I held it up. I was hoping you could see. You pulled out Lilith in exactly the same spot with two completely different decks. That is very interesting. There's got to be a significance to that. What are the chances of that? Like, honest to goodness, that is crazy. You pulled Lilith out. So you pulled Dark Lilith with equality, and then you pulled Lilith with independence. I'm not going to talk about this yet, though, because there's a lot to think about before you get into your next assignment. Because I am seeing the energy of. I'm going to describe this as someone who is, and I want the masculines to stick with me in this too. Like if you're a guy, or even if you're a girl, and or a woman, and you're like extremely masculine, even to the point to perhaps even being like a lesbian, like very like even a butch. I want it because whoever I'm talking to you, and I don't want anyone to feel excluded in this because this energy, we all utilize it and we all showcase it in different ways. This is the energy of someone who people are drawn to you. I don't know why. Well, there's some sort of seductive energy about you, but this seductive energy to me, like either you just come up as really capable. So again, I want to say like if you're a woman, but you would take on a more masculine role in relationships, people see you as their rescuer, like, oh, that's so sexy. She's so sexy. Like she could do everything for me. And if you're, and even if you're not like a lesbian, it could be, even be like that. You could even pull in, I want to say even weak masculine energy that wants to be protected. And that ends up being the downfall of you. And if you're like, just, even if you're a guy here, like even the way I revert, like how that energy is playing out here, because Lilith is sitting here as your next assignment. Actually, I'm not even, we'll see if this is, maybe it's somebody that you're moving towards, but I'm not sure yet. This is not the time, Larry. We already talked. Well, I'm here now, I'm working. Well, come and talk to everybody. I didn't tell them, actually. He went back out and got the squirrels. So if you were here for the Gemini reading, I was giving him a hard time because the squirrels were like, I had to go get Lily. He's been out and he's been working hard. I told them, okay? They know. All right, anyways. Okay. You have a seductive quality about you, and this seductive quality, You end up trapped by it. You end up trapped by it. That's the funny thing that I'm getting here. It's almost as if you, like you come off as being, you are the one with the most power. And I want to say probably a lot of relationship dynamics that you enter. You're the one with the most power because you are drawing things into you. Things come towards you. Things, opportunities, including people. But then I do feel like the squirrel's out there, Larry. The squirrel is out there. Larry, go get him. Prove yourself. Once you draw these things in, they honestly don't want to do without you. So it's almost like you end up being trapped in it. Now, you have a choice coming up. You have a choice. I feel like you have a couple of choices that are coming around to you. You're going to have to use your... What's the word? Your discernment. There it is. You're going to have to use your discernment. So there's something here. It's the Eight of Cups and the Four of Cups. This feels like to me somebody that you walked away from who didn't recognize your worth. Okay? And it's interesting, right? Like you have Lilith. You have Lilith there. So Lilith, right, is never felt equal. Lilith is always about the energy of being on the outskirts, being persecuted for who you truly are, which is interesting because there's independence here. So I think that's who you truly are. But because you have the dark and the light of Lilith, we all have a Lilith placement. So it's as if you perhaps are going from a state where your independence was taken from you and you lost your equality. And now you're moving into a true independent state. But the idea is to make sure you're finding equality over there, wherever that's going. Like, I'm not getting a lot of details about what your next assignment is, but it is, and it's, I want to say it's definitely claiming your independence from something. Some of you may be leaving a relationship. Some of you might be leaving, I don't know. Well, I mean, there is the Eight of Pentacles is here, but most of this feels, most of this reading is energy, to be honest. It's Major Arcana, Wands. There's a lot of Wands here. There's a lot of Wands and Cups. What you're going on with the... Look at this. Your nemesis is the truth about your seduction. Or is the truth about seduction? No, it could be something sort of broader. But you have the King of Wands, the Hermit, and the Eight of Pentacles. I honestly feel like you pull things out of the woodwork. And, you know, like even just thinking out of that term, I think of like I'm hearing powder post beetle, which I believe is correct. I studied entomology for a little bit of time. He's out there again, Larry. Squirrel's out there. I don't know what you're doing. You need to get your ass out there. But like pulling things out of the woodwork to me, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but I don't know where that term comes from. But what I'm seeing is a piece of old wooden furniture and all these little holes in them from these little beetles, like pulling this out. It's almost like it pulls things out so that you can look at it clearly, but it doesn't mean you have to necessarily hang on to it or you discard it. I don't know. But this honestly feels like having walked away from something and walking into the energy of someone that, you know, maybe you had a missed opportunity with. So I'm not sure. It's really funny. Just look at that. Like I've walked away from things, and then, but the Four of, like literally this person is walking right towards the Four of Cups. And maybe that's like because it's underlined, it could be where you feel like you've come from too. Like you've walked away from things, and then the things that you've walked towards didn't even recognize like your value. Or you may even like, well, I don't know, this could be an opportunity for you because you may have even been in a state where you were not connecting emotionally. There could have been an opportunity in front of you, and it was just bad timing for you because you couldn't connect with it. So yeah, actually could come up both ways. If I want to say if that's the case, I feel like that might be a little bit better for you if you're reading this. If you're watching me read this, you have transformation at the bottom with the divine goddess. That's it. This is interesting too. You have persuasion and knowledge. I want to say seduction is a form of persuasion, right? Oh my gosh, right? And seduction has truth and persuasion has knowledge. This is understanding the different ways that I want to say your magnet, let's call it your magnetism energy and how that brings things towards you, you know, outside of using the word seduction or even persuading things. You're magnetic because there's something magnetic here that pulls things in to you. These things might get pulled into you at the wrong time as well, with the Four of Cups, so this could be based on timing. But this is like knowing how to use the energy. And I want to say with that, this like this, if you turn this Lilith from the dark to the light, you're using it for your power. You're empowering yourself with it. You're moving beyond. Look at these tarot cards that came out with it. The Three of Swords, the Five of Wands, and the Chariot. You're moving beyond conflicts between what your heart and your mind tell you, and even the strife, like it is. The Three of Swords is the conflict between the heart and the mind. And then strife, which is like a conflict card, and the Chariot is moving away. You're moving away from that, Cancer. So do keep that in mind. What's interesting, because your superpower is sovereignty. A Gemini got the sovereignty card too. I don't know if you can see, but when I was shuffling, I paused. I was like, what the heck? But so you got it too. You got the sovereignty card, but yours comes with rebirth. I don't remember what theirs came with. I can't remember what theirs was. But this is intense. This is great. I mean, because what does dark Lilith has no equality. Light Lilith has her independence. And so that is like a rebirth. But with Isis here, if that's part of your superpower, I feel like you are a healer. Because Isis healed Osiris. So you are a healer. You claim your sovereignty. So here's the thing. This is like Lilith in the light is the best thing that Adam could have ever had. Because it is. It's Isis. It's like when Lilith has her sovereignty, when the persecuted femininity within all of us has our sovereignty, our freedom to express, our freedom to nurture and love in our own way as well, that when this energy finally claims its sovereignty, it is reborn. It becomes the healer of the masculine. It's weird. This is a big reading because it almost feels as if to have Isis there and then this double Lilith on the other end, because like even looking at the sort of the Egyptian idea of this story was, I mean, this is so powerful. She's like the Empress. She really is the embodiment of the Empress, Isis. I think it's also talked about in terms of, you know, the work that she did with women and children. I think she taught women how to make beer or something like that. I'm like, man, this chick was the bomb. So where I'm going with this too is that the whole idea of Lilith because she wouldn't submit to Adam. I don't know. He sounds like a big fucking baby to me. He wouldn't even do this. I mean, I need somebody to. It's just that. Come on, like a masculine in his real strength is not going to be threatened by a feminine in her real strength either. It's the beginning of the story. So much trouble with the Bible, but it's okay. So it's almost like the masculine has been given this storyline, and the storyline is that you need to dominate and control the feminine. But you see, that's the part here where it gets all screwed up, because the cards that are showing me on the table are what the masculine needs is this feminine independent energy, because that's the energy that rebirths it. Because Isis gives a rebirth. She gives a rebirth here. But it's like the one thing that the Adam or the masculine, I want us to call it toxic masculine energy or unhealthy or low vibrational masculine energy, resists is this, which is its own healing. But because it resists it, it suppresses the feminine energy, like within all of us. There's something so big about having this come out like that right there. So going from struggling for equality, and the only one who really gets you is the snake, because you know, too. I mean, even Eve. So you know, you have Eve. Oh, but it's all her fault. Everything is always her fault. Everything is always. It seems like that, no? It does. It is. Right? So if you seduce things, here's the other thing. If you seduce things and you bring things into you, this is, okay. The other thing I was getting when I saw these cards is I want to say, regardless of how attractive you think you are, there's something about you that you can't help in terms of your magnetism. And that's not your problem. So that's the next thing that I want to say here. That's not your problem, regardless of what you've been told about it. It's not. It is not your problem, because God makes no mistakes and God made you. So if somebody else has a problem controlling, where they're domineering, they're possessive, they're anything that you would associate with very toxic masculine energy, or and then I can't control myself, so I blame you for it. It's not your problem. And that's where I get with this, right? Persuasion, knowledge, understand how to use it so it works for you, so it doesn't work against you, because it's been used against you all this time. And the other, oh my God, you got knowledge twice. How am I not just, okay. Your weakness is your determination for knowledge. But it's like you already know. You already have everything you need to have to know. To understand yourself and understand your path and how to truly claim the right path for you. Like how to truly claim it in a sovereign way. Now, you've achieved something here too, though. I mean, look at the tarot cards that have come out with your sovereignty and rebirth with Isis. You have the Queen of, oh, the Queen of Swords. It's so interesting that I picked this deck this week, because there's only a couple of decks and she's one of them. This is one of them, Heaven and Earth, where she's cut off his head. It's clearly a masculine energy. He's got a beard and his hair and all that stuff. Well, we don't know what the other stuff is, but it's a beard. It's like, so there it is. That, and what, it's like the sword, right? This sword come in and cut it off. I want to say this Isis too is almost like you could continue the story of this and say, Osiris has become toxic. I need to chop him up and I'll put them together again. I'm not saying you should do that with anybody. I'm not. Don't chop anybody up. It's just, you know, it's just metaphorical. So even saying that, I feel like that you have probably taught some lessons to some people in your life from the past that have discounted you, that have maybe seen you as a pretty face and not much else, or handsome face or a pretty boy or, you know, whatever, or a sweetie or a sweetheart or a kind soul, but not really seeing who you are. and the energy has drawn, and you know, you may have even very well drawn things in. You're like, I don't even know how to handle this. I don't know what to do with this. I don't know what, you know, and that is a challenge in itself that you are meant to understand for you, and also to claim your power with that, because this is all about persuasive knowledge. So using your magnetic energy, and again, magnetic energy exists in all of us, whether we're male or female or anything in between. And it is the feminine energy and the things that come towards it. I do want to say that Lilith takes on, I feel like when Lilith is in, we're looking at it in this dark energy, I feel like Lilith takes on a very masculine energy as well. And okay, so I've always been curious about the tail of the snake. Is it's going up to her crotch? Now, if I look at that, it could also be this like very phallic. Like, and sometimes I would look at that and I would think, is Lilith only received pleasure from the snake, from the serpent? But now that I'm looking at it and understanding sort of this with what's coming out in this story, is that Lilith has taken on a masculine energy. She's no longer receptive. So she utilizes the snake and utilizes knowledge, but in like a very masculine way. Yeah. So it's to claim your I think it's to claim your independence from a masculine energy that you have yourself even taken on. Because to be sovereign, like, let's be honest, I mean, she looks hot. She looks like Xena. But she's doing what we would consider a very masculine thing. Like, she's charging forward with her sword. She's in a battle yell. She's getting ready to fight. I want to say Isis just like holds her ground. So this is learning to hold your ground too. Okay, so that Queen of Swords takes you into the Ten of Cups and justice. So this is why this is part of why I feel like you have some choices coming up. I do feel like you might have a choice from someone in your past who didn't respect you or honor you or see you for who you were. Some of you may have a choice that came to you in the past that you discounted because, you know, you were not receiving. You were in a masculine energy. You were pushing things away from you. You were charging towards things. There are at least a couple of different choices coming your way. And that's why discernment is so important. Because there is this choice. I want to say it's actually a choice that you're going to make in the future to be Lilith in the dark or Lilith in the light and independent. I feel like Lilith independent is not necessarily Lilith without a partner or Lilith without, some sort of partnership. Because it's understanding your, like, it's utilizing your persuasive, your magnetic abilities in your favor. And not to the detriment of others, but I feel like others have used you to the detriment of yourself, or you've allowed them to do that. Now, this determination for knowledge, which is your weakness, you have the Hanged Man, the Queen of Wands, and the Six of Wands. You want to see, okay, now what's coming in here is you're looking at something from such a masculine perspective. Because this is almost like the Queen of Wands to have victory with this person. Because over here in your nemesis, this is like seducing Are you being drawn into things too? It's interesting. I wonder if for some of you, I'm picking up on some of masculines in this, who can't help but be drawn into certain things. I mean, you have to face that. It's like, because, right, look at this. I'm working away, minding my own business, and pah, King of Wands. And his fire is lit up, and he's looking right there. The victory with the Queen of Wands. As he's sitting on the table, he was minding my own business, working real hard here. Jeez. So that's interesting. It's interesting how that has played out here. Because your nemesis does feel like, now I'm feeling like I'm picking up on masculine energies that struggle with the feminine energy that I've described here. So I kind of want to say with this, there's like the energy of both energies, yin and yang, needing to be accountable, okay? Because the masculine needs to be accountable for what it is drawn to and what it holds back from. It makes these sovereign choices. And then the feminine, right? So maybe there is something here too where this feminine energy is learning, it's understanding the persuasive abilities that it has. But that doesn't take onus off of either energy. They all have to be responsible. Even if you're like masculine and there's a feminine energy that is standing in front of you like that, and it's like everything you could ever imagine. It doesn't matter. The apple never told you to pick the fruit off of it, did it? You made the choice to go and do that. And I'm not blaming, it's funny, I was going to say Edith. I'm not blaming Edith for that. But it's Eve. And it's funny because that reminds me of like Archie Bunker. And from All in the Family, right? That was such a fascinating, deep show. And she was the sweetest thing. And he was such an ass. Such an ass. He really was. She was so kind and so sweet, and he was such an ass. But yeah, and he did. He blamed her for everything. Blamed her for Edith. It's like such an ass. So where I was going was, I don't want to blame, because I really do believe that taking a bite from the apple was the journey that we were meant to take. Otherwise, we don't have consciousness, and we have to work through consciousness and really see everything that we never saw before to elevate and be something more than just an animal, right? So it's almost, again, like this story of this masculine energy wanting to blame the feminine. Oh, you ate the apple. It's all your fault that we know we're naked now. Weren't we all better off just being completely oblivious? Anyways, I can imagine what some of the comments might be in here. I've already had, actually. I don't know why they pop out of the woodwork. I get these alt-right Christian groups that start coming into my channel. I'm like, oh my God, I've never just met such. And I don't want to say, because I do have some friends that are Christian, and that is fine. And they're nice people. But it's when you just get like, and they're even into tarot, because they kind of understand, like, it's how you use energy. It's not, you do this, that makes you that, right? But that's kind of like, that's even them exhibiting a very masculine energy, like, because I can tell that their channels are new, they're brand new, and then they just start popping up, and they're like, oh, you're practicing with the devil, you're the devil, this is so, like, making it Lilith, right? But it is, it's like forcefully going out and seeking, I'm going to fix you, I'm going to find what I know is wrong, and I'm going to call you out on it, and I'm going to fix you. That's what that energy is. And that's, you know, well, yeah. the story. Persecution and knowledge. It's not easy being a woman on this planet. Or even being a man and being more feminine and a much more gentle, softer soul. The planet is not nurturing to that most of the time. And then you get these issues that I see on the table. I want to say for some of you where there is something about, okay, if you are more masculine and you're trying to understand the truth about why something seduces you so much, why you're drawn to something so much, because there's parts of it that you see in it that are of yourself, okay? And these parts have something to do with, you know, you need to recognize these things in yourself. Parts of you that are kind of lost. And they even could come up as frustrations. They could definitely come up as frustrations. And then others of you, I want to say it comes up in frustrations for both. So the other group is the ones that I sort of originally hit on, where you have this energy that draws things in and really trying to understand the truth in that. Because it's also, again, like you're minding your own business and then something comes in and like, oh my gosh, what is that? Let's clarify. Because this is quite the energy. Let's look right at Dark Lilith and Light Lilith. I know some of you are saying, Cindy, there is no Light Lilith. Oh, there is, because she got a beam of light going right into her head. She got a beam of light going right into her head. All right, Dark Lilith. Your next assignment, Dark Lilith. If you're masculines and you are attracted to feminines, I would say that your next assignment here, if you are healthy, now you don't force this or push this on anyone or show up to somebody and tell them that you know what's wrong with them and you know how to fix it. That's toxic masculine energy. That's not how you do this. But there is something here where you do have the opportunity to transform a feminine energy from being in a dark, unequal, like, well, yeah. This is almost like the only way to be equal is to be a man, is to be masculine, is to take on this masculine energy, where it is to show her that she can be feminine. Oh, what came out? Oh, the Three of Swords. Right, see? So Lilith, independence. But the Four of Wands. Oh my God, that's really beautiful. Right? It's like, wow. That's the happy card. It's the happy card, the celebration card, the getting together card. Is rejoicing this feminine energy. So the Three of Swords, which is here, sorrow. The Three of Pentacles and the Ace of Wands. Wow, this is almost like seeing, this is like someone gets, I want to say it's connected to the Dark Lilith because they both had the Three of Swords, but this, wow, this is not a place for me to build. This is not a place for me to build, right? It's like this realization. Strife, the Five of Wands. The Two of Wands and Karma, Judgment. Oh my goodness, it's like lightning hitting the ground. Bringing in judgment. Karma, a new beginning. It's like judgments have been cast. And then the Chariot. The Nine of Wands and the High Priestess. Oh, this is almost, I want to say the High Priestess is almost the energy that like Lilith would work with. Because it is the divine knowledge in the universe, right? Coming through a feminine source. There was another reading I did. I don't remember which one it was now. And it's funny how these, well, I mean, I guess it's not funny. I mean, we're working with the goddess decks. I should see if I have a dark god deck. I have a god and titan deck. I should do them next week, to be all fair. But there was a message about, it was actually kind of about the persecution of feminine energy. I think what I'm really remembering is a comment that somebody put in, how mankind, who exhibits for the most part this very yang energy, do, conquer, conquer, dominate, control, control. And like how it does that to Earth, And then somebody was saying in the comments, like, well, if you think about it though, and the Earth and the Moon is all feminine, is Mother Earth, Mother Universe, Mother Sun, like all these things that are named Mother or Motherland, like even I think the Russians tend to say that a lot, the Motherland. But yet Russia is a very, very masculine energy. And I'm not saying everybody there is. I'm saying just like in terms of the history and a lot of the politics and leadership that comes out of it. Well, they've never had a female leader that I call, unless I'm missing. I might have missed that in history, but I don't think they did. Right? But yet they dominate the motherland. It's always dominated. So, but the universe is this wisdom. And the Hierophant is the counterpart to the High Priestess. The High Priest is the counterpart. But it is masculine energy trying to dictate and create divine on Earth, but through a masculine viewpoint. She's like, well, it's interesting. This is interesting. This could almost be like, I feel like a collective message, Cancer, that you're pulling out here, but you know, you all live big lives. So let me see. This, your nemesis is seduction. The Knight of Pentacles. It's like a slow burn. The Knight of Seduction and Truth. Seducing with truth. I feel like you even perhaps, the Ten of Cups, you're seducing with truth. Your nemesis. But your nemesis, why did this fall out? The Hermit and the Nine of Swords. Who is this Hermit? It might be someone you haven't seen in a long time. The Ten of Cups is over there with your rebirth and sovereignty, with justice. Who's the Hermit? Four cups, the Queen of Pentacles and the Four of Cups. It is a nurturing, it's something to do like with this, it's nurturance, it's, but the Four of Cups, the missed opportunity. The King of Wands. Justice in the Nine of Cups. That's interesting. I'm going to say, Cancer, I think some of you have already pulled in this Lilith justice energy. You've already done it somehow. So whether through, if it is sort of like a Four of Cups, someone that you met at some other point in your life. So let's see, the Four of Cups. The Page of Swords and the Knight of Wands. What would the King of Wands be riding on? But a Knight of Wands. This person is watching you, Cancer. Or this person is keeping tabs on you. I know that sounds kind of creepy. But yeah. What? The Eight of Cups. What have you walked away from? The Page of Wands, communication. You're like, I'm not talking to nobody. I'm not talking to nobody. Let's keep going. All right, determination, knowledge. This is your kryptonite. Okay, the Six of Swords. You may never know sometimes. The Six of Swords and the Strength card. Oh my God, it's so okay. And then you have the Hanged Man. Determination to know. Why won't the universe let you move forward? But that's what that feels like. Why won't the universe let you move forward? I don't know. There's something maybe that needs to catch up to you. The Hanged Man. The Five of Pentacles. The Five of Wands. The Eight of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles. Oh, there's some. This is seeing. Hold back and see. It's just like struggling and trying to master a new beginning. Like to produce opportunities where there are little opportunities found. You're going through some kind of a lesson here. I want to say that for the first time in this kryptonite section, it feels like this is something that you could overcome. And it has something. The universe will not let you move forward until you have mastered the struggle of lack. And then through that, produce the beginnings of abundance or opportunity. Man, you're getting put through the ringer. I just want to say, with all of the energy on here, these cards, you're getting put through the ringer. So the Queen of Wands, you must be some tough souls because this is a tough reading. The Queen of Wands, the Five of Swords, and the King of Pentacles. Okay. She done some cutting shit out here. This Queen of Wands has cut some shit out. Cut a person out. Maybe this is toxic masculinity. I don't know. Could be. Or toxic masculine. Or it could be a father figure. Or a partner. Or somebody. Or a boss. That's like... Yeah. Victory. Some victory. The Queen of Cups and the King of Swords. This is kind of feeling like, okay, so the way we're talking about things, the King of Swords, in its healthy energy, would be someone who would make an exact decision. Someone who would look at all the rules and weigh it out properly. Okay, I want to say something like a judge, but not the way it's been built here in our society. Because if there's anything that we know about how the legal system works in most places, it's not who or what is the right thing, it is who or what has the most money to back their argument and tie things up in court if that's what they want to do. But the tarot is not really talking about that right now. This is like, because, I don't know, she's cutting this out. This Queen of Wands energy is cutting out the King of Pentacles. And maybe by cutting something or someone out of your life, you do have to go into a period of lack. And then you have to build that up, like your independence, your sovereignty. So this, it's almost like, I just feel, how would I describe it? Almost like this Queen of Cups sends love to the King of Swords. The best way to say it. Like gratitude. Maybe like gratitude. Gratitude because there's victory in that. Sends gratitude to the King of Swords. Because he feels like to me, he's showing up as an androgynous energy that is looking at just things equally. Like it's right, the sword of truth through the heavens. Just looking at truth equally. I really don't have like a full proper storyline for you here. It's just honestly the energy. The energy is so powerful that the storyline is insignificant for me to tell. Not your storyline, obviously, but sovereignty. The Queen of Swords and the Hermit. I kind of feel like there's a masculine energy that has kind of suffered at the hands or been held back at the hands of toxic feminine energy. So this is becoming a really interesting storyline. Because this feminine energy has cut out a masculine and she's showing up as the Queen of Wands. And this masculine is depicted in the pentacle form. And then this other, it's another masculine energy because it's the King of Wands. So it would be, you know, in the same energy as this Queen of Wands. It has come out of something that I feel like was influenced by the Queen of Pentacles. Like both these individuals have dealt with something here, kind of on the same level, but in a different perspective. Because now this sovereignty here is like, well, yes, when you have your sovereignty, we've already seen what this Queen of Swords is. She's like cut off a head. Then this hermit moves forward. Your strength is your sovereignty. When you are sovereign, good things come to you. You will have rebirth. These good things could be people, and I do think they're opportunities. Rebirth. This is your strength. The Six of Cups. Wow. There's that heal, to heal wounds, to heal childhood wounds, to heal someone from your past. To heal things from your past. The Queen of Swords. The Chariot. Perfect Success, which is the Ten of Cups. The Tower. And Justice. There's the Sword of Truth. The Eight of Cups and the Hanged Man. I want to say that some of you might be having a job opportunity or been trying to get a job opportunity. And you need, like, so this doesn't have to be, like, I've left it kind of open. It could be, like, how you've dealt with toxic masculine or feminine energy in a workspace, and then how you find that in a healthy energy. It's everything is relationships though, really. I mean, yeah. Persuasive knowledge. The Lovers and the Two of Pentacles. It's interesting. Divine choices. Could not actually say anything more than that, but divine choices. Persuasive knowledge is divine choices. When you understand yourself, how you draw things into you, how you go after the things that you want, then you will see and be able to weigh out what is your divine path. I don't even know what I would call this. This reading felt bigger than me, like bigger than I was even prepared for today, to be honest. So the Emperor and the Four of Swords, well, that, wow, what a way to end that. Because the Emperor would be the depiction of, could depict it as the toxic masculine energy when it's not in a very healthy form. Very controlling and domineering. And to heal that, to heal it. I don't get paid enough for this. Cancer, I'm going to go do the extended. In the extended, I'm going to ask, what from your past still pulls on you, still tugs at you? What from your future is trying to push you forward? How this push and pull affects you, and how you can allow all things to flow freely. I'm also going to use the witch's incantation. I don't think I've ever used it in extended. I'm going to use it over there so you can get a witch's incantation card. Thank you so much, Cancer. Until next time, do be gentle with yourselves. Bye.